The Rehabilitation of Offenders Board says that over the last year of its operations, more than 100 applications have been considered. Board member Norman Gilbert gave an update on the Rehabilitation of Offenders Act since its implementation on November 1, 2017, during a press conference today.
We have looked at just about 115 applications since we have started to work on application processes from just over 1 year ago. Out of that total I mentioned of 115 applicants, we have had denied 16 applicants. Of all the applicants received by the board, we have just 9 applicants that are female applicants in terms of making use of the facility, and 106 males.
Gilbert told the media many young people are taking the opportunity to erase their criminal records for various reasons. He said that more than 60% of people coming forward are below the age of 35.
And most of the reasons as provided by those persons, we have a number of persons who are looking for employment. Number of persons are also seeking opportunities for them to receive citizenship in other countries around the world. And as a result of that, they require having a very clean record. A number of persons also who are going through visa application processes also require having a clean record.
Gilbert said that most of the offenses to be expunged are for harm, obscene language, stealing, and fighting in public space. People who committed murder, voluntary manslaughter, rape, robbery with violence, arson, and any indictable offense carrying a penalty including imprisonment for a term of 15 years or more of imprisonment are not qualified to benefit from this initiative. The offenders' board members are Lawrence Joseph as chairman, Veronica Charles, Norman Gilbert, Inspector Alfred Pear, and Shonalee Pascal. This board, appointed from January 2, 2018, will serve for 3 years. Cherry and Blackman Stephen, GBN News.